In conclusion, here we go. Nike Alphafly Next percent. I do believe. It's time.
It's time, ladies and gentlemen, full review of the Nike Alphafly Next percent.
And you know, on this channel, I don't do full reviews unless I take a running shoe, whether it's training or racing, past 50 miles. And we took this shoe past 50 miles last weekend in the DGR virtual marathon. Okay, so we are now at 72 miles in the Alphafly, 72 miles. And here's how I got to 72. So I did a 23-mile long run at a fast clip. That was the first run in the shoe. I did a mile repeat track workout. I wanted to see how the shoe would do on turning on the track. And then I did a half marathon time trial, went really well on that time trial. And then the last, just last weekend on Sunday, did the marathon virtual race in the Nike Alphafly Next percent. And before we dive into the specs of the Alphafly, I would be fascinated to be sitting in the boardroom at Nike headquarters in Beaverton, Oregon, as they try to figure out how is this shoe going to play out in 2020 with marathon racing in jeopardy. As you probably heard yesterday, I announced like the Berlin Marathon is not gonna happen on the scheduled date in, I think it's what, late September, because of that limit now to 5,000 people gathering in Germany, no more than. So it's just, it's crazy. But here it is, sure enough, just in case we are racing marathons in the fall 2020 marathon racing season, you'll have the info from me here on the Alphafly. If you wanna go watch my first impressions to see how my thoughts changed, as you know, I put in 72 miles into the shoe, upper right-hand corner to see that vlog from, what was it? A month ago, 6 weeks ago? I don't even remember, but it was sometime in March. Okay, here we go. Drop of the shoe, 7 to 8 millimeters, 38 millimeter stack height in the heel, 30 to 31 in the forefoot for that slope of the shoe, also called the offset. So that's, I like that drop, that's good for racing, okay? And then onto the weight of the shoe, okay? 6.8 ounces in my size, or 194 grams, all right? And I will just announce right now that the battle is upon us. So I think Saturday, all right? Saturday's vlog, when I will record it Saturday, publishing Sunday, I'm gonna give you my thoughts on the Next percent versus the Alphafly. I will just and tell you like which shoe I would choose moving forward in 2020. I will just say the Next percent is lighter, all right? It is lighter. That's the only comparison I'm gonna do today. Okay, moving on to the Adam Knit upper. Fascinating upper material. Tons of innovation here. Okay, I'm not gonna talk about the Next percent. Tons of innovation here through the upper of the shoe, the top of the shoe. I will just say, first of all, heel counter, amazing. Great lockdown as far as the heel, no slipping in the heel. And yeah, really like the heel counter. Now the actual material has been, it's a fly knit material that's been steamed and stretched in the production process, which has allowed Nike to basically use less material in the upper, which reduces the weight of the shoe, but still somehow through the production process, they were able to maintain this contoured fit of the upper through that steaming and stretching process. And I gotta say, I do not like when running, when racing shoes especially, when there's scrunching up happening through the toe box and the vamp of the shoe right here in the front. And that is not happening with this Adam Knit upper. So I really like that. Good work, Nike, thus far on the toe box. Now, I will say though, through the eyelet chain, and I mentioned this, I think I mentioned it in the half marathon time trial when I was lacing up, that, and that was the third time I had worn the shoe, so I was probably at about 25 miles in the shoes, that I was noticing I needed to lace up the shoes a little tighter, which means the Adam Knit material, especially through this eyelet chain on the top of the foot, is beginning to stretch and stretch a little bit more. So the long-term integrity of this Adam Knit material, now I'm at 72 miles, I'm not at 200 miles, but I am noticing I had to lace up a little tighter as the volume increased in the shoe. Just keep that in mind for the uppers. All right, there's the upper of the fly, of the Alphafly. So far, very special. Oh, one last point, I'm sorry. I got one last point is that no water absorption at all. So we sweat a lot when we're running marathons, racing marathons. We're dropping water on ourselves at aid stations, and you don't want your upper of your racing shoe to absorb too much water, because that increases the weight of the shoe actually quite significantly. And so far so good. I noticed no water absorption at all through the Atom Knit upper. For the midsole on the Alphafly, obviously a ton of ZoomX foam going on through the midsole, okay? I mean, just a ton. You've got your AirPods here, okay, under the forefoot. We'll come back to those in a minute. And then, yes, you've got the carbon fiber plate under the forefoot, between the ZoomX foam and these AirPods. And I will just say that carbon fiber plate is significantly wider than the Next Percent carbon fiber plate. Actually, well, I did my own investigation into the Next Percent. So there's the carbon fiber plate there through this guy. We'll talk about this more on Saturday, but I'm just gonna say this carbon fiber plate is significantly larger, which probably increased the weight of the shoe as well. Now, as far as the integrity or resilience of this ZoomX foam, you can probably see the creases there. I'm just hoping, you know, the creases are happening quite a bit already after 72 miles, okay? So, which means just the compression and the energy return through your foot strike, I'm gonna come back to that in a minute, I think is starting to decrease definitely after 72 miles. All right, so there you go. That's the midsole. I'm gonna come back to that in a minute. And moving on to the outsole, the bottom of the Alphafly, exposed ZoomX foam through the heel here, but an enhanced rubberized ZoomX foam on the outside right here through the heel area. And I must say, after 72, I'm pretty impressed with the resilience of this outsole, this exposed, you know, yeah, I'm actually very impressed thus far with the heel. Now, I will say it's a new outsole pattern, absolutely, through the, with also a hole there under the forefoot, probably to help reduce weight, which is, so this outsole, just the whole configuration is fascinating with the AirPods here, and then this outsole pattern. I'm gonna say though, one little maybe drawback to this outsole, I think that there's too much rubber here on the forefoot, which I think increased the weight of the shoe quite significantly. Now, here's what's crazy. Some people, I don't even know how they do this, but some people use the, I see it on Instagram, a little bit on Twitter, they're using the Alphafly to train in. And meaning like as almost like a daily trainer. I guess they love the shoe that much. I would never do that. I think racing 100%, and then as far, you know, if you're interested in the shoe for racing, then maybe some really fast workouts. But if you are gonna use the Alphafly just for racing, I don't think you need this much rubber on this, under the forefoot on the outsole. So I'm hoping maybe Nike down the road, like for the next iteration, I just don't think it's necessary to have that much. I think you could reduce it by at least a millimeter, which will decrease the lifespan of the shoe, but will also decrease the weight of the shoe, again, for the sake of racing, if you're just using the shoes just for racing rather than as a daily trainer. Big topic here, big topic, fit of the shoe. Some people were saying before I picked up the shoe that you need to go a half size down. I opted to go true to size. I'm glad that I did. Yeah, I'm glad. I'm no issues at all. In fact, you know, it's actually a little bit difficult to get the shoe on the foot. It's such a, the Atom Knit upper just is so, I don't know, like it's, I guess through the heel collar, like slipping the shoe on, it's a little bit of a tight fit. So I went true to size. Just want you to know, I did not go a half size down. As far as comfort goes for racing shoes, I'm not that concerned about comfort. The Atom Knit is not, you know, obviously it's not plush at all, but it's not, no issues with comfort of the shoe, whether it's the upper or the midsole. Like, you definitely, all right, there's no ground contact feel at all. Like, you know, you are up there in the sky in the shoe with that kind of stack height. So if you like a shoe that you don't feel the pavement and the pounding on the pavement, this is a good option for you. On to my positives and drawbacks for the Nike Alphafly Next Percent. All right, my positives, out of the box. Out of the box, everybody. AirPods, butter my bread. I mean, I even said it. I remember I said it after the 23 miles. Well, I'll just try and find it right now.
The carbon fiber plate, yes, helping, I'm sure. I could distinctly see a difference with these AirPods through my foot strike.
There you go. Bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. Tons of energy return out of the box, okay? Okay, now on to my drawback. I am suspecting that the resilience of the ZoomX foam and the AirPods is not gonna be as long as we might like. I'm already noticing a pretty significant drop in that out of the box bouncy feel, okay? And we're talking pretty special shoe here, but I think, again, it's made for racing. Like, we're at 72 miles. I know I'm not at 150, but they just don't feel right now like they did coming out of the box, I guess, 4 to 6 weeks ago. Sorry, one last drawback is bulk. They just feel a little bulky underfoot, okay? More so than the 4%. I guess I'll just mention more so than the next percent. It's a wider landing area through the forefoot. They just feel a little bulky, not a major deal, not a deal breaker, but just, you know, a little bulky. Now, how will I use the Alphafly moving forward? You're gonna have to come back to Sunday's vlog. I'll give you my answer once again, all right? I'll give you my answer once again. Who is this shoe best for? Again, someone that likes to be, let's say, completely protected from the pounding on the pavement in a racing environment. If you can be a midfoot to 4 foot striker more so, I think you'll get a little more benefit out of those AirPods, okay, right under the forefoot there. And someone that does not mind feeling a little unstable because you're so high off the ground. I don't mind it at all. It's probably because I'm 5'6", so I'm not that far off the ground anyway, but I could foresee, like, if you're over 6 foot, I don't know, like, what that feels like to be that high in the sky, but anyway, just saying, like, I could see how they would feel unstable for runners. So if you like to feel stable and closer to the ground, this is not the shoe for you. Now onto that price point, $275. $275, Nike. Ooh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Jeez. All right, coming out of the box, first run, 23 miles. I was overjoyed for the shoe. Like, it performed very, very well. But I gotta say at this point that I'm not quite as excited for that $275 price point. Again, Sunday, I'll give you more answers in the battle. I'll give you more answers in the battle on the price point. Sound good? $275 for that price point. In conclusion, here we go. Nike Alphafly Next Percent. I do believe a ton of innovation went into this shoe in many different ways. In fact, I think these AirPods are gonna start showing up in Adidas. I suspect Adidas, because they have a lot of money and it's hard to make something like this in a shoe. Who knows, maybe Hoka, probably not Hoka. Maybe Asics, but I suspect that we're gonna see AirPods in other, even though patents and everything, but as far as, patents and other running shoes and using AirPods, but I think this is a game changer. Also, Adam Knit, very innovative, I do believe, from Nike. So there you go. That's my final thoughts. Overall, it's a special shoe, and we will get you that battle again on Sunday. Okay, there you go, everyone. Question of the day. What is your gut telling you about the 2020 marathon racing season? All right, what's about to go down? I'm getting a lot of messages about Boston happening or not. I'm getting messages already about London and even, yes, New York City, which is the latest, in November, early November. As we know, Berlin appears to be off the table, if not postponed. I don't know what's gonna happen there exactly, but let us know down in the comments what you think about the 2020 marathon racing season, because it impacts the Alphafly a ton as far as how many shoes they might be selling. All right, everyone, there you go. Thanks for being here, thanks for watching. We'll toss it back to the first impression vlog right here from about 4 to 6 weeks ago. Don't remember exactly when it was, but there you have it. There you have it. All right, onward and upward. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.